Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do a room called Active Reconnaissance on Tryhackme, which is created by strategos. So let's dive right into it. The first task is introduction. So let me make this page a bit bigger and let's start in this room. This is the first room of the network security module. We will be focused on passive reconnaissance, which I did earlier. And in this, we will focus on tools like ping, traceroute, telnet, and NC, which means netcat. And in passive reconnaissance, we gather information about our target without engaging direct engagement, without having a direct engagement or connection with the target. But now we are making contact with our target in active reconnaissance. So in this room, we will focus on three main tools: ping, traceroute, and telnet. And okay, so let's start this. Web browser is the task two. So let's see this. On the transport level, the browser connects to port 80 TCP default when the website is accessed over HTTP, and 443 when it is accessed over HTTPS. It is a secure version of HTTP. So it is showing us how we can see developer tools. You can just right click on your computer and click on inspect element, and you will see the developer tools here. Console, debug, network. Showing sources. Okay. What happened here? Okay. So now it is also showing us some add-ons for Firefox, which is Foxy proxy, which I am using right now. Let me show you. It is like a proxy. I have set a proxy for Burp Suite. That is, whenever you are using Burp Suite, you have to go into your Firefox settings and click on manual proxy every time, but you can reduce that step by using Foxy proxy, and you have to just click on here Burp Suite and it will just start your proxy, and then you can intercept all the traffic using Burp Suite. The setting for Foxy proxy is quite simple. You have to just name title of the proxy. I have set it to Burp Suite because I'm using it for Burp Suite. Proxy type is HTTP. Proxy IP address is your local address, that is 127.0.0.1, port is 8080, which we are using for Burp Suite. So then just click save. This is Foxy proxy. Second is user, agent, switcher, and manager, which gives you the ability to pretend to be accessing the web page from a different operating system. Okay, so you can manipulate the user agent by making it think that you are using it from a Windows system if you are using it from a Linux system. That is, you can manipulate it. I'm not using it, so I don't have that much idea about user, agent, switcher, and manager, but I know about Webalizer. It actually tells you about the technology the website is using, which you have visited. As you can see that it is Webalizer. I'm using this tool, this add-on on Firefox. So on browse to the following website, ensure that you have opened your developer tools. Using the developer tools, figure out the total number of questions. So let's see. Okay. Can you hear me, Bob? Yes, I can hear you. Okay, we have to figure out how many questions are there. So let's inspect element. Go to debugger. And I think yes, we have here. We have first question, we have second, we have number before every conversation. So let's see how many are there. There are 8 questions, I guess. Yes, there are 8 questions. Okay, so I have answered this as well. So let's move on to ping. Let's start this machine. Okay, it is telling us to connect to your VPN. It is very simple. You have to go click on your profile, go to access, and from there you can download your configuration file. And in your terminal you have to write open VPN, then your VPN file. I have named it my VPN file to mrrobot_tryhackme.ovpn. You can name it however you want and just click enter. And also one thing, I'm running this as root, but if you don't like running this as root, you can just, you have to type then sudo open VPN and then your VPN file and then click enter. It will ask for your password. You can connect it through this way as well, but I'm already running as root. Okay, so ping is reminds you of the game ping pong table tennis. You throw the ball and expect to get it back. The primary source of ping is to check whether you can reach the remote system or and that the remote system can reach you back. So you are checking if a system is, you know, you can reach a system or not. So on your attack box, ping/c, which means you want to send 10 packets, and then okay, generally speaking, when we don't get a ping reply back, there are a few explanations that would explain why we didn't get a ping reply. For example, the destination computer is non-responsive, possibly still booting up or turned off, or the OS has crashed. Okay, the second is if it is unplugged from the network or there is a faulty network device across the path. The firewall is configured to block such packets. MS Windows firewall blocks ping by default. Your system is unplugged from the network. So there are a few reasons why when your ping doesn't reply. So which option would you use to set the size of the data carried by the ICMP request, echo request? So let's see the manual page of ping. Okay, -4 is for IPv4 only. Let's see, we are looking for to set the size of the data. Okay, packet size. So dash S is the option we use. What is the size of the ICMP header in bytes? See, I think it is right here. The default is 56, which translates to 64 ICMP data bytes when combined with the 8 bytes of ICMP header data. So it is of 8 bytes. So let's type here 8. Does MS Windows firewall block ping by default? Yes, it does. We already read it in the third point here. So we will type Y here. Deploy the VM from this task and issue the command ping-c to specify the number of packets you want to send, and then it has set 10 packets. How many ping replies do you get? We will get 10, but let me show you. Okay, am I connected to the network here? Okay, let's connect it to the VPN again. Let's see. Okay, it is taking. We will see 10 packets here, you know, because we have specified it -e 10. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, we have 10 packet transmitted, 10 received, 0 packet lost. So let's type 10 here. Trace route. Trace route is actually, you know, like it tells you how many hops or routers your computer had to, you know, go through in order to reach the destination. As the name suggests, the traceroute command traces the route taken by the packets from your system to another host. Okay, so it is showing how many routers your, you know, device had to go through before reaching the destination. And okay, traceroute 1 is when it is trying to reach Tryhackme, how many routers your system had to pass in order to reach to Tryhackme. And then trace route B, finally in the, wait a second, trace route B, in trace route B we noticed the packets took a longer route this time, passing through 26 routers. Yeah, I think the previous one was 14 routers. If you are running a traceroute to a system within your network, the route will be unlikely to change. However, we cannot expect the route to remain fixed when the packets need to go via other routers outside our network. Okay, so to summarize this, we can notice the following. The number of hops routers between your system and the target system depends on the time you are running traceroute. There is no guarantee that your packet will always follow the same route. So this time our, you know, you can say that the traceroute B, in traceroute B, the our system took a long, you know, different route to reach to our destination than it took in traceroute A. So some routers don't return a reply. Okay, some routers return a public IP address. You might examine a few of these routers based on the scope of the intended penetration testing. In traceroute A, what is the IP address of the last hop or, you know, IP address before reaching your destination? It is right here, 14. Okay, should be able to copy this, place it here. In traceroute B, what is the IP address of the last router hop before reaching Tryhackme? So it was 26. This is the IP. You can say this is the last router your computer had to go through before reaching the destination, that is Tryhackme here. In traceroute B, how many routers are there between the two systems? There are 26 routers. Okay, start the attack box VM from TASI. We have already started it. It is running. So let's copy this IP address. Trace route C and see how many routers are there between the attack box and the target VM. So let's run trace route this. Okay, there are two routers. It had to go through two routers. So complete this. Telnet. So let's see. Telnet is teletype network protocol developed in 1969 to communicate via with a remote system via CLI, that is command line interface. Command line interface is what I am using right here. Hence the command line telnet uses the telnet protocol for remote administrator. The default port is 23. It sends the data including username and password in clear text. Okay, so that was the problem with this, because it is sending it in clear text. Sending it clear text makes it easier for anyone who has the access to the communication channel to steal the login credentials. The secure alternative is SSH, that is secure shell, running on port 22. So let's see, we can connect to a service using telnet by specifying the IP and port. You can connect to any service running on TCP and even exchange a few messages unless it uses encryption. So okay, now let's say you want to discover more information about a web server listening on port 80. Connect to the server at port 80, then we communicate using the HTTP protocol. You don't need to dive into the HTTP protocol. You just need to issue get, which means get command, which means we are trying to get information from the web server. Slash means the directory. It is like, how can I explain you? It is like, what was the IP? Yes, this is the IP. This and this slash means same thing, which means the, you know, the base. You can say this is the base here. Base website and HTTP, which is using protocol 1.1. Okay, HTTP version 1.1. We can also specify what page we want to visit by specifying, as I told you, it is like the base, you know. If you specify this, okay, let's refresh this. If you specify slash after this, it doesn't change anything because it is, you know, like the base website. Okay, so I think I have explained. So let's start answering the questions now. Start the attached VM from task 3. If it is not already started on the attack box, you open the terminal, use the telnet client to connect to VM on port 80. So let's do this. Telnet IP port 80, and we have to specify I think HTTP slash 1.1, am I right? is the syntax right? Let's see. Slash http slash, okay, it is right. So let's see what we get back. What is the version of the running server and what is the name of the running server? Okay, it was capital get. Oh, my mistake. Why it is not exiting? Get slash http slash 111. Okay, I think I did this right now. I am connected to the VPN, so why isn't it answering? Okay, now it has answered. It took a bit of time. Okay, the server running is Apache and the version is 2.4.10. So let's answer this question, the last two questions of this task. Running was Apache and the running version was this. So let's move on to the last task. So terminate this VM from task 3 and start this. Netcat, we can simply say or and C has different applications that can be of great value to a penetration to a pen tester. Netcat supports both TCP and UDP protocols. It can function as a client that connects to a listening port. Alternatively, it can act as a server that listens on a port of your choice. Hence, it is a convenient tool that you can use as a simple client or server over TCP or UDP. If you have used, Tryhackme or did some room on Tryhackme, you know we always use Netcat whenever we try to communicate when we are trying to get a reverse shell from a system, we always use Netcat most of the time, you know. And that's it. Netcat is used for listening. And it has specifying some options. Minus L means listen mode. Dash P means port number. Dash N means no resolution of host name via DNS. So you don't need to resolve the IP address into a host name into via DNS. Dash V means verbose output. Dash dash V means very verbose. Means as soon as whatever you do, just tell me. Verbose means that showing the output. Dash K means keep listening after the client disconnects. Okay, so start the VM, open the attack box, use netcat to connect to the VM port 21. Okay, so 21 is for FTP file transfer protocol. What is the version of service running? So let's do this and see port 21 IP and port. So okay, FTP service running as I told earlier, which is Linux FTP 0.17. So 0.17 is the version of the service and server version running. So I think we have completed this room, putting it all together. So there are a few examples, ping-c on Linux or Mac OS, for pinging sending 10 packets to a IP, dash n for Windows, traceout on Linux, traceout on MS Windows, telnet port number NC, IP port number NC minus LVNP. When we are listening for a reverse shell, it is saying that netcat here acts as a server. So I think in this way we have completed this room and answered all the questions, and thank you for watching.